Hi guys, welcome back. In this lesson, we're going to look at Errol Garner's Misty. Misty is one of the most popular jazz ballads, and the distinctive melody is immediately recognisable amongst musicians. The tune is written in the key of E flat major, and it follows an AABA form. The tonality is primarily major throughout, and there is some altered harmony sprinkled in here and there. So the version that I'm working from can be found on page 434 of the New Real Book 1. Here's the front cover of the New Real Book 1. If you head over to the resources section of Piano Groove, you can find a link to where you can buy that book online. So this is one of my favorite jazz standards, so hopefully I'll have some interesting things to share with you. So before we get stuck into the chords, let's run through the melody in our right hand and just the roots of the chords in our left hand. Now we're in the B section. Back to the final A section. So now let's add the thirds and sevenths of the chords. This will give you a much better idea of the harmony. So starting at the top of the form, we have an E flat major 7 with the root, the third and the seventh, to a B flat minor 7, so we've got the root, the 7 and the 3. And that goes to an E flat 13, so we've got the root, the flat 7, the 3, and the 13 is the melody. And that goes down to an A flat major 7. So that's a 2-5-1 in A flat major. We have B flat minor 7, E flat 7, and A flat major 7. So that goes up to an A flat minor 9. So we've got the root, the third, the 7, and the 9 is the melody. To a D flat 13. So we've got the root, the flat 7, the 3, and the 13. So notice the movement between them. We have A flat minor 9, then the 7 of A flat drops by half a step to become the third of D flat 13. So E flat major 7, the root, the 3, the 5, and the 7. To C minor 7, root 7 and 3. To F minor 7, so we've got the root, the 3, the 7, and the 3. So that's a B flat 7. We've got the root, the flat 7, the 3. To G7. So root 7, 3, and the root is the melody. That falls down to C7, then to F7, then to B7, and then we're back to the second A section. So let's just run through that without talking. So now we're back to the second A section. This is pretty much just a complete repeat of the first one. Let's run through it again. E flat major 7, B flat minor 9, to E flat 13, to A flat major 7, A flat minor 9, to D flat 13, E flat major 7 to C minor 7, F minor 7, and then we have an E flat 6 chord. So you'd play that like this. We have the root, the third, the 6, and the root is the melody. So E flat 6 would be similar to E flat 7. It's still dominant, but we've replaced the 7 with the 6. And then we have a B flat 9 sus. So the easiest way to play sus chords is to play the root of the chord and then play a major triad a whole step below the root. So that gives us the root, the flat 7, the 9, hence the B flat 9 sus, and then the 4th, which is in the place of the 3rd. So that's a functioning dominant chord. And then we're back to E flat 6, and then we move upwards and we're into the bridge. Now let's take a look at the bridge of the tune. At the end of the second A section, we have an E flat 6 chord, and that takes us into the bridge. So what's going on in that line? So basically we have a B flat minor 7, and then a B flat minor major 7, and then a B flat minor 7. So that might look quite complicated, but in fact it's quite simple what's going on once you understand. So a minor major chord is basically a cross between a minor and a major chord, as the name suggests. So here's a B flat minor 7 chord. To play a B flat minor major 7, we just raise the minor 7th to the major 7th. So we have the root, the minor 3rd, the 5th, and the major 7th. So it's quite a fruity sounding chord. And then and then it drops back down to a B flat minor 7. So let's see how that sounds just with roots, 3rds, and 7ths. Again, going from the E flat 6, we have... So that's basically the root, the minor 7, and the minor 3rd is the melody. So we just lift up the minor 7 and raise it by half a step, and then it drops back to B flat minor 7. So now we have an E flat 7 with a flat 9. So we can play... So that's basically the root, the 3rd and the 7th in our left hand, and the flat 9 is the melody. So the flat 9 is a very interesting sounding note. It's altered, so it's the 9th that's been lowered by half a step. And so I think it's nice to draw some attention to it with a grace note sort of dropping into it. So. So then it goes to A flat major 7. So that's a 2-5-1 in A flat major. We've got B flat minor 7, E flat 7, and A flat major 7. Let's run through that again. So now we have an A flat 6 chord. We can play that like this. So we've got the root, the six, and the third. So that's an A minor 11. We've got the root, the third, the seventh, and the 11th is the melody. To a D7. To F7. And then we have B flat 7. Then E diminished. So we've got the root, diminished third, diminished seventh. So we've got B flat 7, E diminished 7, F minor 7, so root 3, 7. That's actually an F minor 11 because the 11 is in the melody. And then we have a B flat 7, and then we're onto the third A section. So just let me run through the whole of the bridge for you without talking. So going from the E flat 6 chord. So that takes us to the third A section. This is the last A section. It basically brings the tune to an end. So now that we've been through the form adding the thirds and sevenths of the chords, we can now look at adding more extensions. So in particular, we're going to look for opportunities to add nines, 11s, and 13s. We're also going to look at ways that we can embellish the melody to make it sound a bit more interesting. So something I like to do here is to harmonize the pickup of the tune. So the pickup is this bit. And that basically drops you off at E flat major 7. So when we harmonize something, it means that we take those two notes and we build chords underneath them. So as we're going down to E flat major, we could turn that into a major 2-5-1. So here's that's an F minor 11. It's called the Kenny Barron voicing. So you can go and check out the lesson on that for more info. But you can see we've got the B flat on top, so we've not changed the melody. We've just harmonized underneath it. So here we have the root, the fifth, the ninth, the flat third, the flat seventh, and the 11th of F minor. So we could harmonize the G by playing a B flat 13 chord. So we've got the root, the fifth, the flat seven, the third, and the 13. And then we can play an E flat major 13 chord. So we've got the root, the fifth, the ninth, the third, the 13th, and the major seventh is the melody. So we could actually change the melody there slightly as we go up to the top. So we have, I mean, you can play a B flat minor 9 there. So we've got the root and the 7th and the 9 and the minor 3rd. So you can see we do play the C in the previous bar. So, you know, just putting it into that chord is fine. So you can see then I took the melody up. Which is okay. You could also bring it down, so it's just a way of adding a bit of interest instead of playing, you know, four straight notes. So F minor 11, B flat 13, and E flat major 7. B flat minor 9, so we've got the fifth in there as well. To E flat 13. So here I just played the roots and then came up to play the major 7th and the 9th. So that's an A flat minor 9 voicing. We've got the root, the 5th, the 7th, the 3rd, the 5th, the 7th again, and the 9th. So that's a D flat 13 with the 9 in there as well. So the 5th of A flat minor 9 actually becomes the 9th of D flat 13, so you don't need to change the notes. So where were we? So there we've just got, what is that? That's an E flat major 7. We've got the root and the 5th, the 3rd, the 5th, the 7th, and the 3rd again. Just a bit of a thicker chord. We could harmonize these next two notes as well. So all we've done there is we basically moved up diatonically. So we have E flat major 7. And then the melody moves up to A flat, so we can play an F minor 7 chord. So we've got the roots, the 3, 5, 7, and a 3. And then the melody moves up to G, so we can play a G minor 7 chord. So we've got the root, the 3rd, the minor 3rd, the 5th, minor 7th, and the 3rd again. So that passage is... And that goes to a C minor 9. So we've got the root, 3rd, 5th, 7th, and the 9th, and the 3rd in there. So it creates a bit of dissonance and tension. And then we go up to an F minor 9 there. So we've added the 9 in. So here you can play the C and the D together. And we can actually move the sort of outside of this little cluster here, so to get to G7, which is quite a nice touch. So let's just run through all that again. There we've got a G7, and we can keep this bit simple, so C7, F7, B flat 7. So here I just sort of hit the root and the 5th, and then played the 3rd, the 5th, and the 13th. So again, just adding a few notes in. So that's an A flat minor 11 chord. So last time we played, we doubled the 5th. Well, if we drop the 5th in our right hand down a whole step, that turns to an A minor 11. An A flat minor 11. Not an A minor, so A flat minor 11. That 11 really sort of adds some colour to it, so you can hear the difference. To D flat 13. So now let's have a look at the B section. First of all, we've got the E flat 6. We could change that B flat 9 sus into a B flat 13 sus. So B flat 13 sus is basically you play a major 7th a whole step below the root. So last time we just played the major triad. If you play a major 7th, that also gives us the 13th. Of B flat. It's a bit of a richer sound. And then we go back down to E flat 6. So what did I do there? Basically, I played the E flat 6, and then I hit the root of the chord. I played a left hand rootless voicing, and then just raised the minor seventh up to the major seventh. And then I played a rootless voicing with the flat 9 in there. So we've got the 3rd, 7th and the flat 9. We could continue to play sort of the roots and then the rootless voicing. So that's a rootless voicing for A flat major 7. We've got the major 7th, the 9th, the 3rd and the 5th. So here we can play the Kenny Barron voicing again. So remember the Kenny Barron voicing, it has the 11th on top. So that'll work well whenever you have a chord with the 11th in the melody. So here we've got the root, 5th and flat 7th, and we've got the 9th and the 3rd, the 13 and the root on top, down to E diminished 7, so we've got the root, the diminished 3rd, diminished 5th, diminished 7th and the root again, and then we can play F Kenny Barron, could even add the 9 in there, to B flat 13, and then back to E flat major. So that's just an F minor voicing. And that's the end of the tune. So if you have any questions with that stuff, guys, just feel free to drop it in the comment box below.